Hi, my name is Jim Ritter. I'm the Director of Enrollment Management and Student Services here at Kent State Trumbull. And today I'm going to talk to you about campus tours. Now, before we even get into the campus tour, there's one thing you need to know. There are two types of universities or colleges. Ones that have open admission, ones that have selective admission. Open admission means high school diploma or GED, you're accepted. Selective admission means that that school will take certain students based on specific criteria, ACT scores, high school GPA. So if you're going to school that has selective admission, you're going to want to find out what ACT score, SAT score do I need to get in? What type of high school GPA do I need to get in? Now, keep in mind, if you get accepted to a university, that doesn't get you into every single major that university has. So you might want to major in nursing, and you got accepted to that university, but you didn't get accepted into the nursing program. So you're going to want to find out, what does it take to get into the nursing program? What's my ACT score? What's my SAT score that I need to get in? Also, on the other end of that, if it's a major that has something like a state exam at the end, you're going to want to find out, what's the passage rate for the nursing exam? They'll probably tell you something like, well, it's pretty good. Well, that's not a good answer. But if they tell you, I don't know, but I'll find out, you know that's a pretty good school. If they just say, oh, really not sure, not the answer you want. Okay, so let's talk about the campuses themselves. There's two types of campuses, residential campus and a commuter campus. Residential campus means that you live on campus in a dorm. Commuter campus means there are no dorms and you just drive back and forth to class. And obviously some schools have a little bit of both. They have some residential students and some commuter students. So if it's a residential campus, you're going to want to ask to see the residence hall that you're going to be staying in, most likely staying in. Okay, you don't want to see a typical residence hall. You're going to want to see the one that you're staying in. Now, something that a lot of schools are doing recently is they have something called a living learning community, where you're going to be staying in a residence hall with other students in that same major. Very good idea. If you can get into one of those, that's a good suggestion. Also, the biggest reason students leave a school is because they don't like their roommate. So you're going to want to find out, can I room with someone that I want to? Can I pick out my roommate? Or am I just going to be given a roommate at random? If it's a commuter campus, what's the charge for parking? Where do most students park? How far away is that going to be from my classes? How early do I need to get here to get a good parking space? Now, let's talk about classes themselves. Many students ask the student-faculty ratio, and although that's a good question, that means how many students are there per class to one faculty member, a better question would be,